Today's lesson is going to be a combination of the provocations and their covers from Coda Lunga Alta, because it's such a short section. There's only two and a half plays here. And they're quite similar to what we've done before, so it's going to be fairly brief. But there are a few interesting things going on here, so I want to go over those things. So first off, we have a provocation we've already seen in both Sword and Sword and Dagger, where we clear the sword and simply step forward, ending up in Iron Gate. So I'm hitting the sword once with the False Edge, and a second time with the True Edge. If they don't move, I'll doubtlessly be hitting them. If they do move, which is kind of the intent, I'll be in a good spot to continue my forward momentum. So I'm actually making sure as we're doing this, we are hitting the False Edge, then we're stepping forward, and not stepping with the False Edge, because that's going to place it in a bad place. So to clear the False Edge, then move forward with your right foot with the True Edge. In response to this, he proposes this interesting counter here, so that as they hit the sword initially, we're actually going to step over to Cinghiale, putting this in protection of our head. So essentially going to just drive it into their weapon and prevent that second cut from actually happening. This could very easily turn into a reversible leg next. I could continue the thrust to the side, but they come in and just drive into it and add in Cinghiale. Now the second one is a little ambiguous. He says, as we step forward with our right foot, I can do one of two things. So this is going to be a second sequence here. First one being, I'm going to give a false thrust, I'm going to feint a false thrust over the top of their cloak. Now depending on how they deal with this, you can do one of two things. If they come up very, very high, to deal with, to kind of clear the cloak out of the way, that opens up the leg, so we can hit that with a mandrito. So very similar to what we saw with the sword dagger. So feint, cut the leg, and let's get out of there. Feint, cut the leg, get out. As the person responding to this, to raise the cloak up because you don't want to be hit in the face. And then as the measured threat comes, we're going to use the false edge, trade, and throw a reversal to their thigh. So again, we raise this up to prevent the thrust from coming in. Mandrito comes, cover low, trade, cut to the thigh, and then get out. Alternatively, this could be feint and turn this into a punto de reverso, followed by a reversal to the thigh, the right thigh. This could be a case of where they are covering out as opposed to covering up. So we have one, two, three, and out. In response to the punta de versa, which is still starting from raising my cloak, they're going to come to give the punta de versa, whether it's to my outside or to my inside. We're going to use the cloak to defend ourselves, so prepare for this. And do the overhand reversal. I'll start this over. Up high. Cover, and then as the reversal comes, we actually hit the sword arm as opposed to the side of the neck. So we're here, transition, step back on the left foot, and hit the right arm. So that gives us two full provocations. First one being false edge, true edge, against which we just go into each and the other. And we have parts 2A and 2B. Feint the falso, cut the leg. I guess which for you, raise the sword, or raise the cloak, defend the little trade, cut the thigh. And we also have feint high, come here, go to the leg, and get out. Against which we start the same way, we defend and go for the sword arm as the reversal comes to the leg. And that's it. So next video will be on Iron Gate, Provocation and its covers.